on almost the entire subject of thermonuclear weapons, on the problems of their possession, on the effects of their use, there is now practically a total silence in the press, in official publications, and on television. There is hope in any unresolved and unpredictable situation. But is there a real hope to be found in this silence? The world's stockpile of thermonuclear weapons has doubled within the last 5 years. And now is the equivalent of almost 20 tons of high explosive to every man, woman, and child on the planet. This stockpile is still steadily growing.
Tomorrow evening, the BBC is showing its recent film about a nuclear attack, Threads, which traces the events of 4 weeks that lead up to a nuclear war and the decade that follows. Threads is on BBC One tomorrow night at 9:25.
This is BBC One. And now introducing the third film in a week of programmes, 40 years after the bomb.
Good evening. Last night, as part of this week of programs to mark the anniversary of the atom bomb attacks on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, we showed you Peter Watkins' famous film, The Wargame, a horrifying exposition, you may have felt, of the effects of nuclear war. But the political background to it is perhaps less convincing today. And so tonight we are showing what might be called The Wargame's 1980s successor, Threads. Threads, which was first shown last year, is about a nuclear attack on Sheffield, and looks not only at the devastation done, but at the measures taken by government to help the survivors. If the most nerve-wracking aspect of the war game was the noise, that of Threads, you may find, is the silence.
In an urban society, everything connects. Each person's needs are fed by the skills of many others. Our lives are woven together in a fabric. But the connections that make society strong also make it vulnerable.